Hello learners, in this session we will study joint Hindu family form of business organization relating to different forms of organization like sole proprietorship and partnership. We have already covered, and as you know, those type of organization you will find it so easy to cover this session also. Its meaning and characteristics will be learned in this session with its merits and limitations. And at last, we can study the suitability of joint Hindu family form of business organization. Joint Hindu family business is a form of business organization run by Hindu undivided family, where the family members of three successive generations own the business jointly. This is a condition that three successive generations must be there in that business as members of that family business. Joint Hindu family business is headed by the eldest member of that family, and he is known as the Karta. The head of the family, Karta, manages joint Hindu family form of business organization. Head is known as Karta. Then what you will call other members who are managing that business? Because I have already told you, this business is managed jointly by whole family. So all other members who are managing the business, actually who are the owners of the business, are known as co-partners. And co-partners have equal ownership right over the properties of the business in joint Hindu family business. The membership of joint Hindu family business is acquired by birth in the same family. So a newborn baby of that particular family will be a member of that joint Hindu family business. And in this business, there is no restriction for minors to become the members of the business. That is why I have told you, a newborn baby will become a member of the family business in joint Hindu family form of business organization. So as a feature, I would like to say, membership is given by birth, and minors can also become members in joint Hindu family business. We have followed mainly two system of joint Hindu family business. One system, that is Dayabhaga system of Hindu law, which is applicable in West Bengal state. And under this, male members and female members of that particular family have joint ownership in the joint Hindu family business. All other states except West Bengal followed Mithakshara system of Hindu law, where only male members can become owners of the Hindu family business. Members are known as co-partners. So you can say either as owners or co-partners. Who can become co-partners under Mithakshara system of Hindu law? Only male members of that particular family can become co-partners of that joint Hindu family business. Characteristics of the joint Hindu family business includes different factors are dealt with, like formation, legal status, membership, profit sharing, management, liability and continuity. I will explain these characteristics of joint Hindu family business one by one. How this joint Hindu family business is formed? At least two members in the family should be there to form this form of organization. In the case of partnership, we have studied, it is formed on the basis of certain agreement. But in the case of joint Hindu family business, it is not created by an agreement, but by operation of law. There is a law that is, I will explain that later. In this slide itself, I am going to explain which is that law that is governing joint Hindu family business. So it is not on the basis of the agreement, but by operation of Hindu Succession Act, that is Hindu law, this joint Hindu family business is prevailing. And family must have some ancestral property. That is a condition to form this type of business. Some ancestral property should be there for doing this business. Relating to Another feature, legal status. Joint Hindu family business is governed by the Hindu Succession Act of 1956. Remember the Companies Act 1956? Same year, you can remember this act also, Hindu Succession Act of 1956. On its basis, this family business should be run. And jointly owned by the family members. It is not owned by Karta or any one member of that particular family. It is jointly owned business. Jointly owned by all members of that family. Relating to the membership, we should understand, outsiders are not allowed to become the member of that joint Hindu family business. Or outsiders are not allowed to become the co-partner. Only the members of the Hindu undivided family acquire co-partnership right by birth. That is, acquire membership by birth. Only members, that is the family members, can become the owners of that business or members of that business. How profit is shared in joint Hindu family business? All co-partners have equal share in the profits of the business. Even if they are not participating in the management, they have equal share in the profits of the business. Then, who is managing the joint Hindu family business? Business is managed by senior most family member, who is the Karta. Other members have no right in the management of this business, but they will get the share of profit. Karta manages as per his will. So, full authority is with Karta, and if members or co-partners are not satisfied, they have no other option but only to dissolve the joint Hindu family business by mutual agreement. We have studied sole proprietorship form of organization, which is having unlimited liability as a demerit of that form. In the case of partnership also, the same demerit followed, that is, partners have unlimited liability. Then coming to joint Hindu family form of business organization, where Karta has unlimited liability. What is meant by unlimited liability? It means the personal property will also be utilized to meet the business liability. That is known as unlimited liability. And only Karta has unlimited liability. All other members, that is co-partners, have limited liability in this business. That is, their liability is limited to the extent of share in the business. Whether the business will continue if any crisis occurs. Let us see. If there is, as a result of the death of the Karta, the business will be continued. That is, the death of the Karta will not affect the continuity of the business. Why? Because eldest co-partner will take possession of the Karta. So, business will run even if death of the Karta occurs during the life of the business. And co-partner's death also will not affect continuity of the business because mainly business is run by Karta. Joint Hindu family business can be dissolved either through mutual agreement or by partition suit in the court. By filing a suit in the court, business can be dissolved, or by mutual agreement, the business can be dissolved or come to an end. Business can be wind up by making a mutual agreement. In every form of business organization, we are identifying the merits in order to assess whether we can use that as a form of business in the present situation. So, here also we are identifying the merits of joint Hindu family business. Joint Hindu family business assures share in profits for the co-partners. Quick decision is possible. Share of knowledge and experience is possible. Limited liability of co-partners. Unlimited liability of Karta. Continued existence of the business and tax benefits. Let us study this one by one. Assured shares in profit. Every co-partner is assured equal share in the profits, irrespective of his participation in the business. And interest of minor, sick, Physically and mentally challenged co-partners are safeguarded because business is managed by the karta, and these persons will get a share of profit even if they are not participating in the business. Eldest family member karta is fully managing the business. That means he enjoys full freedom in the management of the business. So karta can take quick decisions. There will not be any delay. He need not discuss any of the business matters with other members. It is not essential for him. So he can take quick decisions. This is a merit of this form of business organization. Another merit, sharing of knowledge and experience. Co-partners get knowledge and experience of elder members. Co-partners inculcate discipline, tolerance, self-sacrifice by seeing how the karta is managing the business. These type of knowledge and experience can be acquired by co-partners. Limited liability of members as a merit of this form of business organization. Co-partners liability is limited to the extent of share in the business. And karta's liability, what is the nature of karta's liability? Karta has unlimited liability. Members run the business freely just by following the instructions of the karta. And karta has unlimited liability. So he has more authority and more responsibility in that business. What is meant by unlimited liability? That is, personal property of the karta can also be utilized to meet the business liability. As he has this feature, that is unlimited liability, karta has to manage business more carefully and more efficiently. Continued existence as a merit of joint Hindu family business. Members' death or karta's death will not affect the continuity of the business, because if karta dies, then eldest family member will take over the business and the business will be continued. So business can be continued for a long period of time. Death of any member will not affect the continuity of the business because business is already run by karta. Tax benefit as a merit of joint Hindu family business. Hindu undivided family business is an independent SSC for tax purpose. And share of co-partners is not to be included in their individual income for tax purpose. Now, every form of business organization will have its own limitations. So here also, we have some limitations. We have studied so many merits. So let us have a look at the limitation also. Limited resources, lack of motivation, scope for misuse of power and instability are some of the limitations. Let us study that one by one. Hindu undivided family is owned by one family only. So it has limited financial resources, limited money. And the members are not having that much managerial expertise. So, limitation relating to managerial expertise is also seen in Hindu undivided form of business organization. And because of limited financial resources and limited managerial resources, you cannot form a Hindu undivided family business as a large-scale business. So, not suitable for large-scale business organization. Lack of motivation as a demerit of this form of organization. Co-partners will get equal share in the profit irrespective of their participation in the business. So, if you are getting money without any effort, then whether you will be motivated to put your best for that particular organization? Definitely not. You will not be motivated to put your best in that particular organization because your effort is not at all considered, and but you get regular income. So, this is a demerit of this form of organization. motivation, lack of motivation of the co-passners. Then, scope of misuse of power as a demerit of joint Hindu family business. Karta has absolute freedom to manage the business and there is scope for him to misuse it, that is, misuse that power for his personal gains, and that will badly affect the business in future sometimes. This business will not have a continued existence if there is a small rift within the family members, because by mutual agreement this business can be completely dissolved. So small rift within the family may lead to partition of the business and the business will come to an end, or there will be instability of this business. Always this business is under this threat. Now moving to the suitability of joint Hindu family business. This business is suitable when the family inherits a running business and members want to continue the business. Joint Hindu family business is suitable when there is limited area of operation. Business that requires limited managerial resources are suitable for joint Hindu family business. And limited financial resources, business that requires limited financial resources are suitable for this form of organization. You can form joint Hindu family business dealing with trading business, small industry type, craft industry, etc. So I am summing up formation of joint Hindu family business. A joint Hindu family business is formed as per the provisions of the Hindu law. It continues its existence even on the death of the person who established the business. The successor automatically becomes the co-passner if they decide to continue the business as it is a joint family business. Children become its members by birth. Senior-most member of the family will become the karta of the business. No legal formalities are required for its establishment. It has to be registered with the income tax department to avail tax concessions involved. So, dear learners, in this session, you have learned meaning and characteristics of joint Hindu family business, merits and limitations of joint Hindu family business, and its suitability. Hope you understood this very well. Thank you.